Good morning students, today I'm going to teach 9th maths 3rd chapter polynomials, continuation of the previous video. First question, check whether minus 2 and 2 are zeros of the polynomial x plus 2. So you have to check whether it is a zero of this polynomial. So first we'll write the polynomial p of x is x plus 2. So how to check whether it is a zero of this? Zero, or we can also say root. So how to check whether minus 2 and 2 are zeros of this? What you have to do is, instead of x you have to substitute minus 2 and see. Then again instead of x you have to substitute 2. So first we will substitute minus 2, okay. Put x equals to minus 2. So what it becomes? P of minus 2 is equals to, so in the place of x you will put minus 2. Minus 2 plus 2 is equals to 0. So you got answer as what? 0. So if you get the last answer as 0, then we can say that it is minus 2 is a 0 of this polynomial. This is that 0. Then we'll check for p of 2. So put x equals to 2, that is p of 2. So what it becomes? In the place of x we will put 2. 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. So 4 is not equals to 0, right? 4 is not equals to 0. So this is not. So which is the answer? Therefore, minus 2 is a 0 of the polynomial x plus 2. Understood? If you get 0 as the answer, then we can say that the taken number is the 0 of that given polynomial. So minus 2 is the 0 of the polynomial x plus 2, but 2 is not the 0 of the polynomial because the last answer is not 0, it is 4. Understood? Next question, same way you have to check for this polynomial whether this is a 0. So what you will do? You have to substitute x equals to 4 by 5, right? P of 4 by 5 is equals to 5 into, in the place of x you will substitute 4 by 5 minus 5. Bracket means it is multiplication there. So here this and this we can cancel. So what will be remaining? 4 minus 5. 4 minus 5, which is not, this is the last answer. So this is not equals to 0. So 4 by 5 is not a 0 of the polynomial 5x minus 5. Therefore, 4 by 5 is not a 0 of the polynomial 5x minus 5. Third question. P of x is equals to lx plus m, where x equals to minus m by l. So you have to check whether this x is a 0 of this polynomial. So we'll substitute x here. P of minus m by l is equals to what? L. In the place of x we'll substitute minus m by l plus m. Then we can cancel this and this, right? So l cancel. So what will be remaining? Minus m plus m. Minus m plus m also cancel, becomes 0. So you got the last answer as 0. So what we can say? Minus m by l is a 0 of this polynomial. Therefore, minus m by l is a 0 of the polynomial lx plus m. Next question, find the zero of the polynomial in each of the following cases. So you have to find what zero of the given polynomial. So first question is p of x equals to x minus 5. Second one is p of x equals to cx plus d, where c is not equals to 0. First we'll do for the first one. So what you have to do when they asked you to find the zero of the polynomial? You have to equate it to 0, the given polynomial. You have to take the given polynomial and equate it to 0. Then you have to remain only x in the left hand side. Then everything you have to take to the other side. right hand side. So what it becomes? Minus 5 if you take to other side, plus 5. So x equals to 5. This is the zero of this polynomial. So therefore x minus 5, x equals to 5, right? Therefore 5 is the zero of the polynomial x minus 5. Next, second question, p of x equals to 6x, cx plus d. So we'll equate it to 0. Then you have to take the this d to other side. So you have to remain only x. First we'll take d to other side, plus d becomes minus d. Then c is multiplied here, right? C is multiplied to x. When you take to other side, what it becomes? Multiplication becomes division. So minus d by c, x equals to minus d by c is the answer. Therefore minus d by c is the zero of the polynomial cx plus d. Next question, check whether minus 1 by root 3 is a zero of the polynomial 3x square minus 1. So you have to check whether this is a zero of this polynomial. So what you have to do, we'll take this polynomial first. P of x equals to 3x square minus 1. So in the place of x, we have to substitute this. So P of minus 1 by root 3, that is 3 into, substitute here, minus 1 by root 3. This is whole square, right? Right, whole square here, minus 1. Then 3 into here, whole square, right? Minus, minus minus plus. So when you do the whole square, minus minus plus, 1 1's a 1. Root 3 into root, yeah, root 10 square root and square get cancels. Okay, so what will be remaining? 3. When you square, for example, if you have root 3 into root 3, 2 times root 3, the answer will be 3. Or root 2 into root 2, the answer will be 2. Okay, and these are some important, you should know this. Then root 2 whole square, if you have like this, then here root, square root and square get cancelled. So the answer will be 2. Understood? Same way, if you have root 3 whole square, so square root and square get cancelled. So answer will be 3. Understood? So same way here, 1 square is 1 1 is 1. Here root 3 square, square root and square get cancelled. So will, what will be remaining? 3. Now you can cancel this, right? 3, 3 get cancels. Then what will be remaining? 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is what? 0. So you got the last answer as 0. If you get last answer as 0, then what it is? The given number is a polynomial. Given number is a 0 of the polynomial 3x square minus 1. Therefore, minus 1 by root 3 is 0 of the polynomial 3x square minus 1. Let's take down some homework problems. Verify whether the following are zeros of the polynomial indicated against them. You have to check whether these x values are the zeros of this polynomial. First one, p of x equals to x plus 1 into x minus 2, where x equals to minus 1 and 2. You have to first substitute minus 1 and check, then 2 and check, which will be the 0. You have to check it. P of x equals to x square, where x equals to 0. P of x is equals to 3x minus 1, x equals to 2 by root 3. Fourth one, 2x plus, p of x equals to 2x plus 1, x equals to half. Find the 0 of the polynomial in each of the following case. You have to find the 0 of the polynomial. First one, p of x equals to 3x minus 2. Second one, p of x equals to 2x plus 5. Third one, p of x equals to ax, where a not equals to 0. Fourth one, p of x equals to 3x. Students, solve these questions in your homework book. Thank you.